Optima. This, by far, more than any other vehicle in our portfolio, changed the mind of a lot of folks when they think of Kia. 5 years ago, when we introduced it, we heard a lot of comments from people saying, what was that? What car was that? And you hear over and over about how it turned people's heads and it turned people's minds around about what Optima is all about, what Kia is all about. And so fast forward 5 years, as Michael mentioned, has been our top seller. How do you replace something that's been that successful? Thankfully, we still have our secret weapon and his team in place. This is Peter Schreyer. This was crafted by the same team in the Frankfurt studio that put together the existing car, and with the help of the folks also over in Namyang and Korea. They worked diligently on making sure they understood and kept what made Optima special and carried over into a new one. And it seems like a simple concept, but it's profound. If you think about some of the competition out there, when they redo their cars, the personality or the style completely changes. Folks coming back are saying, well, what is this car? It doesn't look anything like my old car. That's not the case with Optima. We fully understood what made this car important. And when you work with Peter, he's really a stickler about the idea of having very simple, clean forms and surfaces and a lot of confidence in the details. So he pulled forward that same idea with the current one. When you look at the vehicle from across the room or across the parking lot, or if you see it in traffic, it's instantly recognizable as an Optima. And that was one of the key points that we had going into the new car. However, as you move closer, we wanted to put a lot of interesting differentiating details that kind of pull you in and introduce you to the new car. One example is this really cool, bold new interpretation of our tiger nose grille. Satin metal finishes, hot stamped right into the grille, into a black glossy matrix underneath. The inspiration came actually from our K900 luxury sedan. You see it here on this SX model, and also on the SXL and the vehicles you'll be driving today. So just a real nice fine detail touch for the overall vehicle. One of the other one is the signature greenhouse accent. This is that nice chrome stripe that goes over the top of the car. It's a signature that you see on no other car except an Optima. So when you see that chrome signature across the top of the DLO, you know that's an Optima. It was on the current one, and it's also going to be on this new one. And that's really a key point for us going into the introduction of this car. Also new is a very distinct and unique LED tail light. If you're approaching the car from behind or you see it in traffic, you'll see a nice new signature that represents the Optima. So all in, we kept what works and we made some differences on where we needed to improve. One of the first ones is the dimensions have changed slightly. It's overall about a half an inch taller. It's about 0.4 inches more in wheelbase and also overall length. And more importantly, you see it on this car here, and if you compare it to the old one, it's almost an inch wider, and that pays a couple of dividends on both giving us more packaging space for structure, for safety, and small offset, but also more interior room, which I'll get to in just a couple of minutes. By far, probably the most striking improvement has been on the interior of the vehicle, and here, the idea of continuing forward with class-leading design and materials goes forward. And I think this is a key point that we've had in our last three vehicles we've introduced. You've seen it in Seoul from one generation to the next. The Sorento, which we just launched in January, you saw market improvement also in the interior. So it goes for the new Optima. The materials and experience overall in the interior is designed to meet and exceed all expectations of what people think about Kia on the interior. And you'll see it. It's not an easy job because we have to interface a lot with finance and a bean counter, so we have to do a lot of battles to win these things. The first impression when you look inside the vehicle, first and foremost, is this horizontal plane that goes across the middle of the IP. And this does two things. Number one, it mimics the horizon line, so it gives us an impression of a large, roomy interior. But more importantly, it also separates the visual aspects, so all of the visual controls are above the line, and all the physical controls for the switches and knobs are below that line. So it's a nice logical split between those two. Also continuing, one of the design cues that we have from the previous one, the center cockpit and the instrument cluster binnacle is canted towards the driver to give it more of a sporty, inclusive feel, and we continue that on with the current one. Also, the overall impression, because of the change in materials and because of our change in philosophy, is a more luxurious, a more premium aesthetic overall on the interior. And this includes things that the steering wheel I just mentioned to you. It's a new D-shaped steering wheel with fine little jewel details. We put the badge name at the bottom, but also some of the best materials we could find. Available leather and also Napa leather. This is our SXL model, which is a model in the back with quilted, heated and cool seating across the board on the SXL. And also fine attention to detail. This is hand stitching on the leather wrap steering wheel. And also across the dashboard, we have stitching and also the door trim. As a matter of fact, that stitching is so important to us, we had to invest heavily in new technology to make sure the stitching is precise and exact. So that, because it's right in front of the customer's face and on the door trim, it's very important to have the details done right. As I mentioned before, the dimensions have changed, increased slightly. The payoff on interior has been significant. We have, by far, a very roomy interior you'll feel today. Front legroom, front headroom, and also cargo volume are all class leading. These are all better than the Accord, the Camry, the Altima, and even the brand new Malibu. And you'll see it when you experience it today. The rear seat in particular, because of the increase in height, it gave us more packaging space for more rear seat headroom and also rear hip room because of the extended width. So overall, a very nice interior to spend time in. In particular, we bring attention to a brand new front seat design. It's not only a new design, but also a new a supplier for us. This shows some of the attention to detail that we've gone into to develop this. Starting off with a very rugged, very durable, high tensile strength steel frame. This basically forms the foundation for durability and long-term for both driving. If you're in and out of the vehicle a lot, if you hear some of our competitor vehicles, they start squeaking, you hear this noise, or if you're driving the car alone on a bumpy road, you'll see some of the seats moving around. That doesn't happen with this new design. Four-layer foam support, you can see some of the cutaways here. Adjustable lumbar, improved thigh support. Also, we've increased the use of a little soft headrest, so you can adjust it both in and out. And more importantly, we've added, Lauren, specifically for you. We've added across the board on all Optimas, we've added adjustable passenger seat height adjustment. And also, for passengers, we also have a new 10-way power adjustable, including power lumbar. So no more complaints from the passenger and the driver having different controls. We're the only one in the segment that has this has this feature. Excuse me. So all in, you'll have a great time in our new seats. Also, continuing on with, we've been a pioneer in adding new features to this category, to the midsize sedan. Panoramic roof, we were the first ones out there with that. Heated steering wheel, electric parking brake, that's new for us this year. Heated power folding mirrors, and also rear passenger sunshades on the side window. So if you have little passengers in the rear seat and you don't want the sun blaring down into them, you can flip those up and it gets the sun out. Also, first for us is a rear seat. A rear passenger USB port. So if you have passengers in the rear that need to keep their phones charged up, they can plug them in.